All right, folks, thanks so much for being here. Welcome to Smalls. How's everybody feeling tonight? We got some great music coming up. Please bring your hands together and give a warm round of applause for the great Leighton Harrell on the upright bass. And the piano is here for Emmett Cohen. Of course, leading this wonderful trio on the drums. A big round of applause for the incredible Joe Farnsworth.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out on this very special Monday night. For us, it's always special because this is why I live in New York City, to play with the best players, and there's no one that makes me happier on piano than the great Emmett Cohen.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you very much. I don't take that for granted. Thank you very much. Thank you. And we have a guy, this is like a Emmett old school way, you know, showing up at clubs and improving yourself and playing tunes, and then you like you get mad because he's so good and so happy, and then you just realize, well, that's just greatness there. Then you overcome it, and then you become great friends, and that, you know, that's what you do. And then I met this guy, I guess you'd call it new school style. I saw him during COVID online. I'm like, hey, what is a nice looking guy? He's got that nice little mustache. I always wanted one like that. And then he's up in Toronto. I said, what's he doing up there? But he's from North Carolina, then he's Montreal. But what got me was that he was playing quarter notes and talking about Paul Chambers and Doug Watkins. I'm like, wow, what young guy is talking about Paul Chambers and Doug Watkins? I was like, we gotta see what he's up to. And every day he was up to something. And I was like, it'd be nice to meet this guy. And then I started talking to him. And lo and behold, 2 years later, here he is, man, in flesh, right here, Leighton. Leighton Harrell. Ladies and gentlemen, give him a better round of applause than that. This is your first time at Smalls? This is his debut at Smalls. And when I came to town in 1986, I was in college, one of the first groups I saw was one of the really the last of the great bebop groups. And that was Junior Cook and Bill Hardman and Mickey Tucker on piano, sometimes Walter Bishop, Paul Brown on bass, and the great Leroy Williams on drums. And as great as they sounded on the bandstand, they were even hipper off the bandstand. They would sit there and talk to you and discuss things with you. And Leroy was the very best. If I was going at 100 million miles per hour, he was going at 20 miles per hour. So I was like, slow down for him, slow down. And he had this cigarillo and his like khaki jacket and khaki pants, a little hat, and he's always talking about the one time he played with Monk, and that's what we're gonna do tonight. You know, we talked about what we're gonna play, but Leroy told me he played with Thelonious Monk for a couple weeks at the Vanguard, and he's like, hey Monk, what are we gonna play? And Monk ignored him, and then the next night, hey Monk, what are we gonna play? And then Monk ignored him, and then the third night, he said, Leroy, we're gonna start swinging, and we're gonna end swinging. That's all you need to know, and that's good enough for me. So we're gonna start swinging, and we're gonna end swinging. And what the main other thing he taught me was that, and Ari Rowland actually expressed it to me, which is quite true, he made you feel like you belong. And you know, there was always like us, and then there was guys like Roy Haynes and Junior Cook and you know, Clifford Jordan and those guys. And it always seemed like they were superstars and we were like in double A or something like that. And there was a big gap, and there was. But Leroy was the first guy to sit and talk to you and made you feel like you belong. And I think that's imperative for us today, to make these young guys feel like that they belong. And hey, man, you feel like I belong. So that's why I'm so happy to play with him tonight. Thank you very much, man. This is for Leroy Williams and Barry Harris. We're gonna start off with some tunes by Leroy play. And this is two tunes by Cedar Walton called Cedar's Blues and Fiesta Espanol. Thank you.
Thank you.
that was our Cedar Walton portion of the Leroy Williams tribute. I was thinking while I was taking my drum solos, you know, I'm getting ready to take my kid to college, so there's a lot of feelings about that. You know, my first child, 17, so sometimes you come to the drums and just work it out, and as they say, beat your way through life. Well, as I was taking a solo, I remember me and Leroy sitting on a bench outside to smoke, and he said, yeah, you know, Farms, I remember when Papa Joe Jones came into the where I was playing once, he said, Leroy, it sounds good, young man, but why does it take you so many beats to play a solo? And I said the same thing. Leroy was telling me, Farms, why are you playing so many beats in your solo? Well, Leroy, sometimes you just got to work it out. Anyways, we'd like to continue on with one of the mainstays of New York City. It was the Barry Harris Trio, and Barry died a little bit before Leroy died, and Barry made a video for me, and he played this old song, but the message at the very end was very, very important. It said, no matter the cost, be the boss. Be the boss, no matter the cost. And so that's one thing that I'm trying to learn coming out of this COVID. So we'd like to play a couple of Barry Harris tunes, and would you want to play a ballad first?
Yeah.
And then we'll go into...
Let's play the ballad first and see.
Yeah, down around the corner. Yeah, okay.
Can't plan too much.
Thank you. Thank you.
gentlemen, we'd like to do a tune that reminds me of one of the tunes I saw Leroy play with Junior Cook, and this is called Walkin'. And I was out in a bar with Junior Cook in 1990. It first started off, I was in college, believe it or not. It was my fourth year, and I had a jazz history class. And I was failing it, because I was going into Brooklyn and playing with the great Bill Hardman. So I was wondering, what's really more jazz history, the class out in Jersey or Bill Hardman's house in Brooklyn? Anyways, I went to play with Bill Hardman, and through Bill Hardman, I met the great Junior Cook, and through Junior Cook, I met Leroy Williams. And I was out playing with Junior when Leroy was busy, and I kept bugging Junior, like, what can I do? How can I play better? He says, leave me alone, stop bugging me, just keep playing. And he had this kufi on and these sunglasses. You never saw his eyes. And then one time out in Brooklyn, the jukebox came on. It was Miles Davis walking with Kenny Clarke and Percy Heath. And he took off his glasses and said, listen to the cymbal beat. He says, that's all I want. That's all anybody wants. And it was a big moment in my life. And that was through Junior Cook. And we'd like to give Leroy Williams a great round of applause. Leroy Williams. Yeah. Thank you.
give it up for the great Joe Farnsworth and Jim Petrillo. Joe Farnsworth, everybody. Folks, thanks so much for being here. Thanks for coming out and supporting live jazz music. Unfortunately, I cannot ask you to stay for our next set because we are sold out, but we have this kind of music every night of the week, and we hope to see you very, very soon. One more time, give it up for great Joe Farnsworth and Jim Petrillo.
Thank you. Well, in the border. We're going to play a little competition. Anyway, this tune that passed through my vessel started to be a
subject yesterday.
Alright folks, thanks so much for being here. Welcome to Smalls. How's everybody feeling tonight? We've got some great music coming up. Let's bring hands together and give a warm round of applause for the great Leighton Harrow on the upright bass. Again with the great Emmett Cohen. And a forbidden and wonderful trio. On the drums, a big round of applause for the great Joe Farnsworth. Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Joe.
Anyways, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out tonight. Tonight is an impromptu dedication, homage to one of my great, great friends, Leroy Williams. Leroy Williams is one of the great drummers from Chicago. He was great friends with Wilbur Ware. And he moved to New York City in, I'd say, late 50s. And he was one of the greatest, smoothest drummers around. And I used to play with the great Junior Cook a lot, and John Orr from Thelonious Monk fame. And Leroy would sit in, and he would play things that I'd never heard before. Like, you know, a lot of people, well, me. Oh, that's Philly Joe Jones there, or that's Art Blakey there, or that's Billy Higgins there. Leroy played Leroy Williams, and he played, like, Present Time. It was astonishing the things he played. Hey, be quiet for a second. I'm talking about Leroy Williams. Unless you're talking to Leroy Williams. Shh. I shouldn't have said be quiet. I'm sorry. Anyways, I'm so excited to play for Leroy Williams. He died a couple months ago, and he was the drummer with the great Barry Harris. And one of the things that he taught me was how to be compassionate and how to reach out to other people and make them feel like they belong. And that's a very important lesson to me, because a lot of times you want to not help out or mind your own business or, you know, be selfish. But Leroy Williams went out of his way to make you feel like you belonged in this musical community. And we used to have ice cream all the time. And I'd have my ice cream in like 3 bites, and he'd take like 50 million bites to eat his ice cream. And he would look at me. He was having ice cream and smoking Tipperillos, and he'd say, "Slow down, Farmzy." And the reason why he called me Farmzy, because my name is Farnsworth, and I introduced myself to Max Roach a long time ago, and Max Roach heard it as Farmsworth, with a F-A-R-M-S. So every time Max saw me, he says, "How you doing, Farmzy?" Anyways. Does anyone have a better Max Roach story than that? Anyways, we're going to reach out to a young man. First of all and foremost, the reason why I live in New York City is to play with the greatest. We have one of the greatest over here, Emmett Cohn on piano. Come on, let's turn it up. Yeah. On bass, making his debut in Smalls, Leighton Harrell on bass. And we're going to start off with a tune that Barry Harris liked to play. And it's one of those adult tempos called Out of Nowhere. And we're going to, in honor of Leroy, we're going to reach out to a young man I've never met before or even heard before. But word is that he's the next John Jenkins on alto. And he's from Toronto, Canada, Brent Parmar. Brent Parmar, come on up. Thank you. party going. Sonny Rollins says, don't stop the carnival. We like to bring up a friend I've never played with before, but I love her online, and she's a great up-and-coming singer. Her name is Julie Music. Julie Drew, come on up here.
Tonight.
Joe Farnsworth and the Jonas Shakira on the coin. Arthur Merrill. Well, thanks so much for being here. Thanks for coming out and supporting Live Jet Music. If you like what you hear, then you should stay for our next set. We have another one coming up in about 25 minutes. Miki Yamanaka is going to be here with your trio, and the music is going to be very exciting. If you cannot make it, we have this kind of music every night of the week, and we hope to see you very, very soon. One more time, give it up to Joe Farnsworth and his wonderful trio.
Thank you, Carlos. Thank you, Carlos. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you again. I want you all to go home and say a prayer for the Williams family. This is a tribute to Leroy Williams, and you have to ask yourself, try to make someone feel like they belong tomorrow or in your life. Try to go outside yourself and make them feel like they belong, like Leroy Williams did for us. Thank you very much.